So we have our last person for the lightning talk. We have Oluwaseun. He's going to be talking on engineering for wellness. Please, a round of applause for Oluwaseun.
Hi, everybody. Can you hear me? Can you wave if you can hear me? Okay, awesome. My name is Oluwaseun Raphael Afolayan. People call me Raphael, and I'm CTO at mytherapist.ng. What we do is provide teletherapy services to Nigerians. Next. Okay, today I'm going to be talking about workplace anxiety. Next slide. So yes, hi, I'm Raphael, like I told you. Next. I've been a contractor for most of my years. Next, the usual stuff is to, you know, execute a project, get paid, and go home. But sometime last year, I joined a team, really big team of about 50 plus engineers. And then everything was going great, interview process was fine, but then when the actual work started, I got really anxious when I was meant to begin the role. Next. And this anxiety impacted my productivity as well as the team I was supposed to lead. Now, the elephant in the room is workplace anxiety. I believe that's what everybody here wants to talk about. That's what everybody here wants to know. Next. Now, it's something that I've seen is more common than we think. There's so many people that I've had the opportunity to mentor. There's people that I've worked with that have not been able to be productive because of workplace anxiety. They join a team, even people that have been in teams for like years and all, they get new members, and this feeling starts to you know, creep in. Next. Now, workplace anxiety looks like, you know, next slide, please. Yeah, next. Just keep playing. Yes, you have difficulty concentrating. You try to seclude yourself from people that you're meant to, you know, to work with. Next, you become restless at work. There are sometimes where you're not even able to communicate. And sometimes you could even get irritated, you know, with the thought of going to work because it's becoming a challenge for you. Next. And if care is not taken, if it's not managed, it can develop physical symptoms like headaches, stomach aches, and all. Now, it's something that I believe 99% of us here have had to battle with if you've worked in a team. But the number one way that I always tell people to manage this is to build resilience, first of all. You need to learn how to take care of your mental health personally, because if you do not, this thing can creep in and affect the rest of your team as well. So you can see things like stress management, mindfulness practices, you know, and self-care generally. There are things that can help you build resilience and help you stop being anxious. Next. Now, for team leads here, or for people who manage a team or are in areas of power, it's important to promote a supportive culture. Next, and play on. Now, picture this. A workplace where open communication, next, empathy and understanding reign supreme. This is where everybody feels valued and heard, and everybody feels that, okay, the next person working with me is a human being. This person can make mistakes. And because, again, there's so much that people who are joining the team, first of all, feel that they think, okay, for example, in my case, I had the chance to work with engineers who had worked at Google, who had worked at Spotify, and the rest of them. They were all in my team, and I was just a contractor. You know, I felt everybody was a superhuman, and I was an impostor or something. Yeah, but then the only way that I was able to get over that was understanding that the next person to me, even though this person had 10 years of experience, was a human being just like me as well. Next slide. Yes, and one thing again is to know how to manage your workload, even with anxiety. There's, you know, please, next, and keep playing. Yeah, so I've highlighted some tips here for managing your workload, especially if you're someone that has to deal with anxiety. I know proper planning next, prioritization, delegation, as well as setting realistic goals next. And yes, thank you very much. That is the end of my talk.
Thank you.